one of my coworkers said, I wonder who the third one's going to be because they always come in threes. And off the top of my head, I yelled, Bob Saget?
Craig, you are forbidden from ever saying my name again.
Understood.
If it comes up, you will refer to me as Mr. V.
And then Jake Atlas does a springboard, and he lands on both feet because he's supposed to get super kicked, and he just collapses. That's all it took.
So his problem is not with Mr. Stink. He wants to know why this little kid worked for Stink.
I was wrong. I was wrong about you, Stink.
Hook versus Aaron Solo. Hook was taller, but he was noticeably leaner and lankier. He still has room to grow physically.
No shit, look at his father. Yeah. Father's built like a fire hydrant.
I mean horizontally.
Hook is built like a hose.
That's exactly right.
Thank you. I hope she's all right, because she's a dentist.
You talked about the
Did you know that? She's a dentist?
I've heard.
Okay. She's a DMD. That's what that stands for.
Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, can I go now?
I think so.
Okay, you sure?
No, of course I'm not sure.
Okay.
But you may as well start. He's going to take a drink of water or something.
One side of the split screen, there's a brawl going on, and the other side of the split screen, there's Mark Henry's giant head.
He just did his big smile.
Yeah, it was the smile. It was the smile that made it.
They had an issue. The options were, you know, have one of these other champions defend, and I guess, you know, they book pretty far out, and so they know what they want to do, and they didn't want to waste one of those matches. And so what they came up with was an interim title. So we'll see how it plays out, but not really a fan of interim titles.
This was the very first Battle of the Belts, which I think they want to be their Clash of the Champions. We started off as mega shows for, I don't know, a half dozen of them or so, maybe a little more. But this in no way felt like a mega show.
Felt like another Rampage.
Granny, when Santa left to deliver presents, which direction did he go first?
Oh my gosh. South.
Correct. Because he's at the North Pole. Doesn't matter where he goes, he's going south.
He could still go north from the North Pole because the goddamn fucking world is round.
Yes, but every direction is south, dumbass.
Every direction is north. It's round.
No, no direction is north.
Dude, get out of here, you
two. He's at the North Pole.
Get out of here. It's called the North Pole, but the Earth is round. Therefore, you can go north from anywhere all the time.
Absolutely.
Am I wrong? I mean, yes.
Yes, yes.
I don't know if this was math or what it was, but basically, they show a teeter-totter, okay? And then they got, you know, two things. And she gets to drag one thing to one side of the teeter-totter, and she gets to drag the other thing to the other side of the teeter-totter. So the teeter-totter then is either equal, or one side goes up, or the other side goes up. You know, there's like a bunny and an anvil. And so she puts the anvil on, and the thing goes kshunk, and she puts the bunny on, and the bunny stays there. And then it goes, which is heavier? I would say that 2 times out of 10, I got it wrong.
What?
She did way better than I did, is the point.
Is this a private school you're paying for? Or,
No.
Lesnar comes out. Newman is bragging about how great Lesnar is.
Newman?
What is that guy's name? Paul?
Paul Newman, of course.
Nyman. Nyman. Is it Nyman?
Paul Neumann?
Hello,
he builds
Brock.
Microphones.
Madeline the Hun.
Excuse me.
Now I can't find it. Tony Jones plus Sang Hun. Whoever that is. Oh, that's the one. That's the Hun. I had two of those.
So is it Sang Hun or Madeline the Hun?
Yeah, Tommy Jones.
Tommy Jones.
Tony.
Tony Jones.
Tom Jones.
Not unusual to be loved by anyone.
It's Tommy. Tommy hasn't had a move. Tommy won that one. From Hun.
From Hun.
What a mess that is. Guess I gave you guys a lot of laughs tonight, huh?
My jaw actually hurts from laughing so hard.
Do you think she's been experimenting with, like, acid or something?
No, she's experimenting with being 92.
I see.
If you want to show some alien civilization pro wrestling, like, just show them this interview. It's like classic pro wrestling.
You're not going to pick, like, Tiger Mask, Dynamite Kid, Omega Okada, some great Ishii match. You want to show him
Hulk
Hogan beefcake promo?
You see, if there are aliens, there's a decent chance that if they find us, they will want to eat us. and or kill us and or take over our planet. So it'd be a good distraction. You know what I'm saying? They'd just be staring at the screen and you sneak up.
Bob Backlund never once turned his face to the camera in this match. For his intros, his back's to the camera. He's waving the crowd over here. He's facing off here. When he celebrates, he's pumping his fist up here.
Vince asks Randy Savage, who's he picking? And he says, Rick Martel. And then Vince asks Rob Bartlett who he's got. And with, like, no comedy, no, just deadpan, he goes, didn't you tell me Perfect's winning, Vince? And no. Vince, like, cuts him off right away.
I did not guess that.
This Dynamite show is weird, dude.
A bad show.
All I hear is that I'm on the payroll for AEW. Bryan's on the payroll. Bryan's on the payroll. Blah, blah, blah. Man, I do any criticism of an AEW show, and boy, do I just get fucking skewered.
Yeah, yeah.
Jiminy Christmas.
Britt Baker lays out Statlander. Adam Cole lays out Orange Cassidy. And Cole demands his kiss from the Bucks. But Britt says, no, I'm going to kiss him this time. And boy, howdy, did she. Wardlow goes for yet another powerbomb. Punk just collapses flat to the mat. Can't even get on his hands and knees to get powerbombed. And then when Wardlow tries to pick him up again, Punk hits the surprise small package out of nowhere and wins.
And the whole segment that I watched with MJF, CM Punk, and Wardlow had me looking past what is supposed to be the big match to a different match. Therefore, I didn't like it. Mm-hmm. Is it the end of the world? No, I see people are freaking out already in the chat. Got it. Punk is not main event anymore. When the fuck did I say that?
Powerhouse Hobbs versus Dante Martin. The big, scary heel overwhelmed the small baby face and beat him up in a methodical manner for several minutes on end. I thought I had hit rewind. I was watching the same match twice in a row. There you go. Lance Archer, your next challenger for the world title. But I was certain that Adam Cole was going to be the next challenger. But
well, Adam Cole is going to be probably the next pay-per-view challenger. But yeah. The pay-per-view isn't until March. It's like their fourth match together, and they shot an angle to do more matches.
Yes.
Like, has anyone had more matches together in the history of AEW on television than Serena Deeb and Hikaru Shida now? I don't think so.
Julia Hart eventually waves them off, still wearing her eye patch, when Malakai Black spit the black goo in her face.
Bro, you know what happens when she pulls that eye patch off?
It's not going to be pretty.
She's going to have the same eye
yes.
as Malakai Black. Oh, I just can see this. I see all of this in my head. And by the way, Brody King debuted immediately afterwards. Huge pop. But dude, this guy's going to kill somebody with these dives.
These dives are not
every
safe.
Single one of his dives, it's impossible to catch him. Like, literally all you can do, and this is all Daniel Garcia did.
Turtle.
All you can do is duck.
Yes.
Every time Sammy comes flying, Garcia just ducks. Because yep. all you see is an ass flying at you or a knee
back.
Flying
yes.
at you. It's like, you can't catch this.
It ended on a high note, at least Dynamite.
It ended on a high note, everybody. It was fine.
Yeah.
Just wasn't the best Dynamite I ever saw. It's all right.
Braun comes out, and they begin to chant, you deserve it.
24 matches in his fucking career,
you
won the title, and
the
he gets a you
guy.
Deserve a chance.
Damon Kemp versus Cameron Grimes.
Yeah, Damon Kemp. They mentioned that he comes out of Minnesota. And they're like the home of Brock Lesnar, Shelton Benjamin, and Olympic medalist Gable Steveson.
Oh, man. Yeah.
I'm like, you mean his fucking brother?
And Vic Joseph tells me, a grown man, don't count out Enofe and Blade. They could win the whole thing. These fucking geeks that you just murdered in front of me, you slaughtered them like cattle in front of me, and now you gotta tell me they can win your shitty tournament? Your tournament sucks. You've killed this tournament before it begins. I've seen a lot of shitty tournaments of pro wrestling. I don't know if I've ever seen one murdered like this before it even began.
Every time one of these fuckers got this crowbar, they couldn't do shit. And then the other guy would beat their ass when they have a fucking crowbar in their hand. And then the guy would grab the crowbar, and then he couldn't do shit, and the other guy would beat his ass. I was laughing my ass off watching these two idiots.
The first spot is somebody charges with a lariat, and she like yawns and leans back and ducks. And it's like, ha-ha, she did that. But then she starts to wrestle, and she begins to whip ass. I guess this is their version of sort of like an Orange Cassidy deal where someone's playing mind games and getting their opponents to underestimate them. And then when it's time to go, they can go. AJ Styles versus Grayson Waller.
Good match.
Grayson's really good. The main event was very good. There was some other fun stuff.
So, yeah, y'all happy to know that AEW still won?
No, yeah, it won by a lot. A lot. A lot.
I should have voted for NXT just to really... for some people's buttons.